Good day. Ngayon naman, didiscuss ko sa inyo kung paano nyo naman sasagutan yung module 3B ninyo sa sit work na Let's Take the Challenge. Yan. Yung sa Let's Take the Challenge part ay problem solving yon kung saan kakailanganin ninyo ng concept ng combined variation. Okay? Ano ang combined variation? Ang combined variation, another physical relationship among variables na kung saan, okay, usually, involved siya ng direct variation at saka inverse variation. Ang direct variation ay multiplication. Ang inverse variation ay division. So, kaya naman, kapag meron tayong statement na Z varies directly as X. So, yung Z daw equal siya sa KX. Okay, bakit siya varies directly as X? So, K times X. And inversely, so divided by as Y. So, Y. So, pag translate itong statement na to, magiging Z is equal to K times X over Y. Pag binasa natin to, magiging Z varies directly as X and inversely as Y. Alright? Yung K dito ay yun yung constant of variation. Alright. Example natin, mag-translate ng statement into mathematical equation. Okay? Gagamitin natin pa rin yung variable k para sa constant of variation. For example, t varies directly as a. Ayan, so ito yung mga natin. Gagamitin natin variable. T varies directly as a and inversely as b. Ayan. So, inversely as b. Directly as A, so T is equal to K times A over B. So, ganito ang translation niya kapag ganyan yung statement. So, basta pag directly, times yon. Inversely, divide. At huwag kakalimutan yung constant. Next example, Y varies directly as X. Yan. So, y varies directly as x is y is equal to kx. Yan yun. Pero, meron siyang and inversely as the square of z. So, over z square. Bakit may z square doon? Kasi because of the word square. Yan. Because of the word square. So, ganyan ang pag-translate. So, magiging y is equal to kx over z squared. Pag binasa to in a sentence, magiging y varies directly as x and inversely as the square of z. Alright? Paano naman mag-solve ng problem gamit yung concept ng combined variation? So, may problem tayo dito. The volume V of a gas varies directly, yan, as its temperature T and inversely as its pressure P. Ayan. So, step 1, translate natin. Ayan. Step 1, translate natin into mathematical equation. So, the volume V is equal to varies directly as temperature T. Ayan. So, varies directly as temperature T. So, K times T. Okay? Times yun kapag directly. And inversely, inversely as its pressure, which is represented by P. So, inversely siya. So, divided by P. Yan yung translation natin. Okay? Step 2. Yan. Step 2 natin, if the V or volume is 80 ml, okay, when T is 30, oh, so meron tayong volume na 80 ml, yan, 80 ml, milliliter, at meron tayong, ano yung T, temperature na 30 degrees, yan. Okay, so, gagamitin natin itong naunang value ng volume at saka T para isolve muna si K. Yan. Okay, solve muna natin si K. Pero, meron pa dito. And the T pressure is 10 kg per square centimeter. So, sulat mo rin. So, T is equal to 10 kg per square centimeter. So, gagamitin natin itong tatlo para solve si K. Para sa step 2. Okay? So, V ay 80. So, substitute lang natin. So, magiging 80 is equal to, wala pa tayong K, kasi ito muna yung solve sa step 2. K times yung T, temperature ay 30 degrees. So, times 30. Ayan. Over, divided by, or inverse less P, which is, ito, 10. So, mapapansin ninyo, ginamit natin yung unang values ni V, T, at saka P sa problem. Para isolve yung K. Para isolve yan, this is over 1. Ayan. So, K times 30 is equal to 30K. 30K times 1, so 30k lang din. So, 30k is equal to, cross multiply na to ha. Ayan. Ito naman, 10 times 80, magiging 800. Times kasi yan, 80 times 10, or 10 times 80, 800. Para makuha yung k, divide both side by 30, divide both side by 30. 30 divided by 30 is 1. And we do not need to write that. So, K na lang. K is now equal to 800 divided by 30 is equal to, pag kinalkyu mo, magiging 26.666667. Pero, we get only up to 2 decimal places. So, magiging, and round off na lang. So, 26.667. Value of K pa lang yun. Ang tanong, what will be the volume? Yan, what will be the volume? So, hinahanap yung volume. So, step 3, ayan. So, solve na natin kung ano yung unknown. Ano yung unknown? Yung volume. Ayan, ano daw yung volume? Yan. If T is 20, ayan, T is 20, gagamitin na natin ito, 20 degrees. And P is, yan, P is equal to 20 kilogram per square centimeter. Yan. Ngayon, anong gagawin? Balikan mo ngayon yung original equation. Ito. Si volume is equal to or varies directly as T and inversely as T. Substitute lang, volume, wala. So, V is equal to, may nasolve na tayong value ng K, which is 26.67, times T, which is eto na, yung pangalawa, so times 20, okay, divided by P, ayun na yun, na hindi pa nagamit, so divided by 20, ayan. So, pag kinalkyu mo to, 26.67 times mo sa 20, okay, equal yan sa 533.4. Yung sagot dito, divide mo sa 20, magiging sagot ay V is now equal to 26.67. Since we are talking about volume, ang unit na nagamit dito ay ml. So, lalagyan din natin ng unit na ml. So, ito ngayon, yung magiging final answer dito sa problem ninyo, sa problem, sa example problem natin na number 1.